So hello and welcome. I'm Frederick Dunn and this is The Way to Bee, and this is a quick tip today. Look at that yellow jacket on the landing board of my flow hive. This is not good news. Look at all the detritus out there. Look at all the scrambling around that's going on. Guess what you're witnessing? Aside from the collection of a yellow jacket, we are seeing a robbing situation. Here it is, state of Pennsylvania, 62 degrees Fahrenheit outside, and it is November the 4th. And this beehive, let's be honest, is a total loss. So late in the year, this colony was light to begin with. They weren't bringing in stores very well. They weren't gaining weight like the other hives were. There goes a ladybug on the landing board there too, and wouldn't you know it, that's one of those invasive ladybug species. And look at Bombus over here. A bumblebee, also satisfied with all the resources it gathered from this undefended hive, and now it's just basking in the sun. These bees are skirmishing a little bit, but guess what? There are no guard bees on this landing board. There are screens, you can see bees behind it trying to get out. Why? Because they're unfamiliar with the entrance of this hive, and that's because they're all a bunch of thieves. With the yellow jacket in the middle there, another ladybug, same one. Little friend, the yellow jacket over here. I'm trying to give them unpleasant experiences, and I'm going to talk a little bit about how to do that for the robbers, too. They're all robbers right now. Look at that yellow jacket down below there. But the yellow jackets aren't the problem. Let's be honest. It's the honeybees that are all getting in here from other beehives in my own aviary. But when you see a landing board like this, see how messy it is? Now they've been dragging everything out, running across with their sticky feet. They're cutting open capped honey inside the hive. This time of year, they all want those carbohydrates, so that's what they're robbing out. Notice none of the bees that are going in have pollen on their legs. They're not bringing groceries with them. They're just here to take. And it's your job, of course, to shut them down. You're probably sitting there watching this video right now wondering, Fred, why aren't you putting up a robbing screen? Why are you allowing this chaos to continue? And look, there's our little friend, the paper wasp there. These are some of the most laid-back wasps you'll ever have around, and I like them. They make their little paper nests. I even let them occupy boxes that are empty, of course. I set them up as pest control. We like them to be here. They're not going to attack any honeybees. That little paper wasp is just trying to get an opportunity to grab some sweets itself. Because even these little bits and pieces that are on the landing board have some nectar and honey in them, maybe even some pollen. That's why you see it pause and chewing there at the little bits and pieces. So they're being robbed. Look at the yellow jacket at the top there, looking right at the entrance. Now the screens are in the way. I'm going to have to pull the screen out on the left, which has the dead worker honey bee sitting next to it there. I don't know if that was a casualty of war, but she's dead. She's going to go away too. So I'm going to pull that out of the way, and I am going to install a robbing screen. I'm going to explain a little bit about robbing screens while we watch the carnage happening here on my 8-frame flow hive, which is a 6-frame flow super. There again, the bumblebee, just like Thanksgiving, overfed, lounging in the sun, just taking in those calories. Did I mention that it's windy? Very windy today. Gusty windy. But we have the warm weather, so the bees are out foraging, and that's just par for the course. This, the good news is the only hive right now that's being robbed. So let's get the screen out first of all. Reach up there and pull that out of there. It's propolized in. The reason I put screens in is, of course, to reduce the entrance so there won't be any robbing. And these flow hive bottom boards have a 3/8 inch high entrance there. Also, we have the screen on the right, which lets ventilation occur while restricting entry so the resident bees can defend their hive. I know you've got questions. This is a Ceracell robbing screen. I also recommend the one sold by Better Bee, the BeeSmart Designs robbing screens. They're white. They all stop bees from getting in as well as getting out, and then you control these entrances, which are supposed to benefit the resident bees, but the resident colony in this case is so weak they can barely help themselves. So once again, I don't want them to have a good experience, so I'm going to grab that yellow jacket there too, so he can go back to her nest, his nest, whatever, and tell them, don't go to this beehive, you'll be grabbed, and it will be unpleasant. I also want to frustrate the bees that are coming here to rob, but look at the bottom here. Because the flow hive landing board has an angle on it, it leaves little gaps, so the robbers are squeezing through the front. You'll even see some coming out here. Look at that, squeezing out, getting away. I don't mind that they get away, but you know what? I don't want it to be easy for them. Our job is to make it difficult. We want them to go back to the hive that they came from and let all the other would-be robbers know that there's no free meal here anymore. So anyway, I put those 3/4 inch screws there, 3/4 inch in length, of course, not diameter. And then we've got these openings at the top. We can let the bees out in little groups. And then I put a screw there through an actual vent opening. This is for an 8 or 10 frame landing board, by the way. And they come in different colors. Look at this ladybug here. That's right, that's the invasive species. Look at the little W there, that little black segment. These aren't even good ladybugs. We can't even feel good about that. So we fix their wagons here by putting a little shim piece of wood in the front, so now nothing can get in or out unless we decide that they can do it. So that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to open the blue one or the red one. But first, I want them to be frustrated in there. Those are all the robbers panicking right now because they can't get out of the hive. And they're on a time schedule because it's going to be cold and dark by 5:30. So they have to hustle this time of year. Let's let a bunch of them out. There they go. Also, pay attention to see. Bees can figure out these alternate openings and try to get themselves right back in. Look at that one going down and in. Bees are smart. That's why we have to be smarter. We have to mess them up with these screens and blocking systems. You can make your own. There's lots of guidelines online telling you how to make a robbing screen. But I keep these on the shelf ready to go for situations just like this one today. So happy Monday to all of you. Look at that yellow jacket there. There's no shortage of yellow jackets. They're everywhere, but you know what? Not very aggressive. Let's grab that one and give that one an unpleasant experience as well. Hold on to it for a little while. Make sure it misses its time to be home so it doesn't bring a bunch of its nest mates back with it. So the Ceracell there, oh, I'm going to poke this one while I'm at it. I don't even want the bumblebee to have a good experience. Get moving. There you go. See, she's ready to go too. She really didn't want to take a nap right there. Let's harass everything here and get them away from our hive. So, slow motion. I know you wanted it. Slow motion sequence. This will let us slow down and see what's really going on. Look at these bees coming. They're expecting a free meal. There's no forage in the environment. There's no nectar out there. There's no pollen. So why not just go to some hive that's loaded and take what you want for free? They didn't forage for the resources in this hive. So it's our job to put a stop to it. More slow motion. But this time, of course, with the sound of the wing beats of the bees going, I want you to look at it while I talk about things. First of all, what are these bees that are coming to rob doing? They're going straight at the open vents because they smell the resources inside. They don't live here. So they just rush straight at this robbing screen. Now, of course, what I'm going to do is open up the blue or the red alternately, and I'm going to let them out after they're adequately stressed. In fact, the bees that are in here aren't even the residents anymore. I'm pretty sure that the resident colony is all but gone completely. And why would they be robbed in the first place? Well, late season swarm. Not unusual in this neck of the woods. We have 2 big swarm seasons here in the state of Pennsylvania. And so after the swarm, what do they have to do? Well, of course, when they swarm, they send out their queen that's been laying eggs in the hive, and she's responsible for reproduction inside the colony. And then they send out a virgin queen at the end of the year. The worst time of year to be sending a virgin queen out. Why? Because there's predators everywhere. There's dragonflies, there's birds, there's other insects, there are hornets. Everything wants to munch on other insects on the wing. So at the end of the year, sending out a virgin queen to a drone congregation area, hoping that she comes back mated, is a huge challenge. Sometimes this time of year, you might find a colony that's just completely empty, and you think, well, they absconded. There was something in the hive that they just didn't like. Or the queen was never mated. And then what happens? 3 weeks after that, the nurse bees that were left behind activate their ovaries and they start laying drone eggs. And then you end up with a bunch of little runty, underfed drones at the end of the year. Or if they didn't have the resources to do even that, you know what they do? They just start dwindling. That means they live out their normal life expectancy and they just die, normally outside the hive. If you look in front of the landing board of this hive, there are not a bunch of dead bees there. So there's no mass extinction event going on here. This is what we call dwindling. So I put the screen on, even knowing that the residents have no chance, because I don't want other colonies in my apiary to get all the honey that's stored in there. Why not? Well, I don't want them to mix it up. And the odd chance, by the way, that there was some disease, we don't want to be spreading that around either. That's why we put the robbing screen on. So you need to have robbing screens handy. When you find a situation like this, you can't just make one. It's best to have them already on the shelf somewhere. So I have Ceracell and BeeSmart Designs robbing screens. This is the Ceracell version. You can get these at the Blythewood Bee Company. I'll bet you can get them other places. This is not a promotion. This is all my stuff. And I'm just letting these bees out after they've been through a period of detention. The rest of them are going to stay in overnight. And when the sun rises tomorrow on Tuesday morning, I'll open it back up and let them go out, and then I'll close it again and start the autopsy on this hive. Thanks for watching.